Welcome to my channel where we look at makeup, unbaggings, random chats, having snacks.
Hey guys, so we're using the new camera. I just had to put on a couple more lash extensions because the left side always looks a little weird. So I got rid of the strip and I just did real quick. Hopefully those will last. We'll see how long. The right strip is curling a little, but I don't do whole strips. I do partial strips. So we'll see. Hopefully the glue will hold on through at least today. Oh, dang it. Awesome. One moment while I fix that and then we'll get on to getting on. These ones, like the other sets that I did, I prefer to glue them on top of the lash line. I want to try below the lash line this time. And it's fine for the most part. And I took one of my cheap brushes I got off of Amazon because I did quite a few of these for like liquid eyeliner or like gel eyeliners. And I use that for the glue. And I think it works quite well actually. As this comes off. Oh, it's working great. Well, the brush works great. My skills at putting on lashes, not so much on the left side. Only on the left side. I only struggle on the left. See, I can do this exact same on the right, and it comes out great. Do it on the left, and I look wonky. Awesome. Oh well. Let's try. So, we're gonna try this. I got it's the Golden Rose Stick Foundation, and I got it in color 03. I know that, we're going to use this. No, I organized my drawers, you guys. Organized. I'm going to use my Rimmel. Mattifying primer. All right, so I got this Golden Rose Stick Foundation. I watched, Taylor review it in one of her 15 days of foundation, and it looked good, looked interesting. Wanted to try it. Try it, my G36. Oh, this is gonna be too pink. I did not realize this. I should have got one. This is super pink. Oh my goodness. So far, I'm liking this camera a whole lot better, you guys. We'll see. We'll see how the sound is afterwards. A sparkly background. movie magic. Excuse me for a moment. Oh, never mind. Oh my goodness.
I am definitely not a pink undertone. This is looking super pink. I should have got the one that was a little bit more yellow.
Wow. But that did go on super smooth.
It's super pink, you guys. It does not.
Wow.
You can't tell how pink it is right now.
So a little bit more. Before it needs a little bit more. Alright, it goes on pretty smooth. It's not bad for $6.99 off of Amazon.
Definitely should have got one shade lighter.
But it is definitely not the right color. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little bit of my Mary Kay CC cream, and maybe that will fix it. Get a little bit more yellow up in here.
The CC cream, I usually don't recommend using a brush. Mary Kay recommends you use your hands, your fingers to smooth it on, and I usually find that I get the best result that way. But if you do use a brush, stipple it. Or you're just gonna wipe the product away. That did not help. Well, okay.
It looks super pale on the viewfinder and the camera, but it's not super pale, but it's definitely not matching my neck.
It is definitely a little bit of a mess. combo will warm up to my face. Because this is how we're rolling. Okay, we're going to try the Wet n Wild mattifying. Come on, focus. Focus. Not focus? Okay. It's not a super fancy camera. But the Wet n Wild mattifying powder in Matte About You. Cruelty-free, Wet Wild. It's 0.21 ounces. It says, feel shiny within, not without. Revolutionary light reflecting powder. Contains porous silica beads, which absorbs oil and minimizes shine. Lightweight powder feels weightless on the skin without adding color and sets with a luminous, soft focus finish. Directions, use alone or over makeup to set and seal foundation. Brush powder lightly and evenly over face and neck. May be used throughout the day for both touch-ups and to get rid of shine. You know, I think I need concealer today. You know what? Let's use Wet n Wild. I'm gonna need powder for my under eye because I use the Coty for my under eye. That's not my favorite. I should have been prepared. I was not. How are you guys today? Oh. As soon as I get done with this, I'm gonna go get some coffee. I have an end of the year barbecue I gotta go to. Appointments, you know. And it's Father's Day weekend when I'm filming. So that'll be fun. Just kidding. Oh shoot. I'm getting Coty powder everywhere. See if I can't set this nose a little bit. This brush, this G33 brush, picks up so much powder. I think I just rubbed off some of the powder on my nose. The foundation on my nose. Oops. Okay. My tried and true, get all the sapphire hair out of there, my tried and true E1. Immediately takes that shine down. Mattifies it. So hopefully that means I won't get super greasy throughout my day. For whatever reason today, the concealer is not giving me coverage. It looks like where I rubbed the concealer, it rubbed the foundation off. Yeah, it is flaking. Oh, and it's clinging to some. I didn't realize I had dry patches on my face. Well, apparently I have some dry patches. see that. It's a little too blown out on the camera right now. But by the big window, and the light is just shining in, making things way too bright. Okay, so we'll see how that powder does. And as per usual, my nose starts running the minute I start doing makeup. The huge. Of course. Okay, so. Sephora for my, I should have took everything out of the drawers. I slept in late. I'm getting a way later start than I anticipated today. Probably shouldn't even be filming, but I'm going to. Because, well, I was going to do my makeup anyway, so might as well have y'all along to make it with me, right? Still trying to figure out this brow game. See if we can make at least sisters, right? Oh, I don't know where that went. Crap. Oh man, you guys. When I film with my iPhone later for a check-in, I'm gonna show you what's going on with my forehead. I don't know what's happening. It is emphasizing everything on my forehead right now. It is looking crazy. I don't know what's happening with my life. All of a sudden, I can't do my left brow. Oh my God. And it's not like this product isn't super easy to work with. It is. And like, I'm struggling all of a sudden. Came in too cocky. I came in too cocky to the game, the brow game today. Yep, it's a little bit of a mess, you guys. Especially what's going on my forehead. I have no idea what's happening there. Let's clean that up just a tiny bit. Scrolling through Facebook this morning, watching some Britain's Got Talent. Watching that 15-year-old boy sing. And I loved how when because I saw the audition and then I saw his semifinal. They're like, oh yeah, I was told to. Get a singing teacher, and they all immediately looked at Simon Cowell. And they finally showed a clip for a semi-final audition on David when he said it to him. They found the clip. And to a 13-year-old boy, that could be very harsh. So I'm rolling today. Super arch. Nice arch. Super arch. Nice arch. And I know it may not, to us as adults, we're like, oh, well. That wasn't that bad. Yeah, that's closer. But to that young man, that was probably super harsh. And let's be honest, if we're super proud of something and we get told, you probably need to see a singing coach. You're not going to be the most receptive to that either. So good for him for coming back. I think that match is better. Now I can see why gurus don't do this on freaking camera, guys. Holy shit. No, but seriously, because I honestly didn't think it was that bad the way he said it, but I'm an adult. And he could have said it a lot worse than he did, but he didn't. Now, I didn't listen to the audition. They just showed the clip. My makeup is a hot mess today, you guys, but I don't have time to redo it. What we got is what we got, what we're rolling with. I hate that. As soon as I start filming, as soon as I put foundation on my face, and there is no turning back. Ulta bronzer. This is such a pretty color. I'm really hoping I can make it work. Oh, yes. So that is rubbing off the foundation on just the left side. What's going on with my left side? That happened last time too. I think that looks good, you guys. I thought I paused. I didn't. Was it a whole witness at my door? Because I thought I heard hollering. Sometimes I get really nervous when people come up to my door. Because I don't like for people to know where I live and stuff. I'm just a little paranoid, I don't know. Either way. Packed in makeup. Eyeshadow primer. Always set your creams with the powder. All of a sudden, I don't have a voice. I don't know what happened there. What kind of look am I going for? That is the question. My Tarte Make Believe in Yourself palette, just cause why not? I love it. I'm obsessed. Little myth. So if you notice, I'm not really opening my eyes, because I have hooded eyes, and I want you to be able to see the eyeshadow, so, you know, I'm putting my transition on, wearing a, looks more blue on the camera, but it's very gray and smoky, and I can't help but want this color fairy, because I love purple. And it's funny too, just thinking about opening your eyelid like this actually takes practice to be able to open it with it being, close it with it being, open it, close it like this with it being relaxed and still be able to see out of your other eye. More practice than you think. I think it might be just a one color day. Just because I got such a late start to my day. And then my eyelashes went crazy. So I had to deal with that. And I need to go to the store. Pick something up for the barbecue.
signed up for dessert. But I will probably... This is a M515. It's so cute. It's so cute. It's perfect for inner corner. Oh, I need more highlight than that. Oh, I didn't do blush or highlight before I did my eyeshadow. I'm trying to get better about filling out my description boxes. Not that people really care about my description boxes, because I'm not a person that people really follow. And I do this just for fun. I know I say that in like a lot of videos to try to, people are like, oh, well, you know, maybe she's just doing it just for how crap she is. I don't really care. You think I'm crap? Great. Great. I'm okay with that. Too many. True Match 1-2 Warm. Oh. I like me. As long as I like me. I like the way my makeup comes out. I think it's very pretty. It's very elegant. No-name brush for my highlight today. You know what, I need to find my highlight my sister got me. I like to mix this and this. For super subtle highlight. These might be too subtle for this skin tone right now. There we go. Now I can see it. My Betty Luminizer, I need to find that. Of L'Oreal True Match. This, holy crap. You want ice at affordable price? That will ice your face up. I made the mistake of like going crazy for a job interview. I didn't think it was that bad, and then I showed up and the way they were all looking at me, I went might have gone a little crazy with the highlight. Alright, this is already a super long video, partially because of a little interruption, and I will I think I will do at least one check-in to see.
see how it goes. Now that I've kind of warmed up the face, I don't think it looks that bad, you guys. I definitely look, my pores are definitely emphasized super up close. And I'm not super happy about that, but everything else looks good. My nose looks a little weird, but we'll go with it. Alright guys, we'll see you in a little while.
I finished my makeup about 10:20, 10:30. So it's been on for 3 hours. And it is looking a mess. It's wearing off and it's breaking down on my forehead and my chin. And watch. That is with a powder and setting spray. And it is sliding everywhere. I still have a couple hours left to go, but this foundation is a no. It's too pink. It's not sitting. I don't feel greasy. I don't. But I know I am greasy, so I need to fix that. I will probably be just putting a different... I'm going to try to fix this somehow because I still have quite a day. And like my forehead. Oh my gosh, you guys. Look at it. I haven't even touched my forehead and it's wearing off weird up there. Yeah. No thank you. Alright guys. I hope you enjoyed that video. There's more where that came from. Random videos about random things. And just having fun. I don't do this as a professional job. I just have a lot of fun with it. So